My name is Archie Lee Collins, and this weekend, two kings will be crowned. Charles is first, and then me. I plan to reunite the original cast, or one person, from the original Bring Back series, and I want to prove to the world that I have what it takes to set off and pioneer my own series. I want to bring him back, I want to interview him about his time on the show, and I'm going to watch Star Wars with him, keeping it relatively thematic and similar to the original shows. This is Bring Back the Bring Backs.
The next thing that I had to do was get the right gear and get kitted out and look like a presenter ready to start my show and find Justin.
Now that I'm kitted out, all I need to do is pinpoint where exactly I can find Justin. And I have a few clues. These Polaroids look a little suspicious. There's a few useless ones, a few useful ones, but there's times he's been spotted nearby. I can't quite work it out, but I'm seeing some familiar outfits, some familiar looks. This place looks familiar. There's parks here, there's park rides, little swings and spinning roundabouts. I think I know just the place to try.
The first stop on our list is Camford Park. He's been seen here a couple times recently. We've had photo evidence, we've had people spotting him, Twitter posts, selfies been taken with fans. We know he works around here, and if I'm not mistaken, that's him right now. I've lost him. We're gonna have to follow down this way. He's just down this way. We're gonna get around the corner and we'll see if we can get him for an interview now. Ah. He's just got in his car. It's heartbreaking. There he goes.
We're gonna have to go back to the drawing board for this one, see if we can find somewhere else again.
Here we are. We're back here again. After a heartbreaking attempt to get him at Camford Park, we're back to the drawing board. So these two, useless. However, similar outfits again. I'm seeing anchors, I'm seeing hot air balloons, some water, some boats. The only place this could theoretically be around Bristol is the Bristol Harbourside, a very, very frequently visited spot. And it looks like I might be right. We're gonna grab the fateful jacket here and head on down, I believe. This is probably our last chance. I have to find Justin now, or it all falls apart.
So with that in mind, now I had to get down to the Harbourside as quickly as I could and find Justin. There was no time to lose.
Okay, today we're on the Bristol Harbourside looking for Justin. This is our last chance to find him. We've been told he frequently comes down here for walks while he's here. And we're currently hiding out at a restaurant he comes to. And we're probably going to be here until we find
him. Quick, that's him over there!
Go, go, go.
We have to go, come on.
Excuse me, hi, are you Justin Lee Collins?
You know I am.
Of course I do. Right, my goal today is to become the next host and presenter of the Bring Backs. I'm going to bring back the Bring Backs, and for that I need to know everything I can. So, in typical style, can I interview you about your time on the show, what it was like, any tidbits behind the scenes you can give me, anything like that?
It would be a pleasure, Arch.
And in another typical style, the reunion side of the Bring Backs, to round out my own version of it, would you like to come back and watch A New Hope with me, one of the things that I believe inspired the greatest of all of the episodes?
I would love to.
Well, there we go.
And after that, we headed back to the house to interview Justin about his time on the Bring Backs and find out what we could.
Right, good to see you again. Hi.
All right, Arch.
For starters, before we kick this interview off, I've thrown myself a Bring Backs outfit together. I've got the jeans and the jacket. Quite typical for your outfits back in the day.
You look awesome.
I've got the same jacket from the Justin Lee Collins Good Times book as well.
Cover, yeah. It really suits you.
Yeah, it's good. It's good to sort of change up the style of it.
Yeah, it looks great. It suits you a lot better than it ever suited me. Definitely. And the t-shirt.
You've got your, yeah, I've got my bring back Christmas number one t-shirt. You've got the I'm Your Father kind of fitting t-shirt for the interview as well.
Yeah.
So, let's get this kicked off with your time on the bring back. Do you want to explain a little bit about it and sort of how it...
Yeah, how it first came about.
Yeah.
Well, it was... I was working at the time at XFM, which was the radio station in London. And I remember being there quite clearly. So I'd just been asked to host a programme called Bring Back Spandau Ballet. Now, you've heard of Spandau Ballet. They were a huge band in the 80s, and they'd split really quite acrimoniously. And it was litigious. They ended up in court, and there was a whole... You had the Kemp brothers, Gary and Martin Kemp, on one side, and Tony Hadley, the lead singer, and other members of the band, I think, on the other side. And the idea was to try and bring Spandau Ballet back for like a reunion concert. So I don't know how much of that you'd like me to go into, but if I cut a long story short, after being given a dossier on Spandau Ballet about this thick, which I brought home just before Christmas 2004, it would have been, to do my research on Spandau Ballet. So I knew everything there was to know about Spandau Ballet, reading everything that had been compiled in this file on the whole history of the band, only to be told, I think, the other side of Christmas 2004, I think I've got my timeline right, that it's not going to happen. We're not going to do Bring Back Spandau Ballet. We'll never be able to bring back Spandau Ballet because of the court case.
Yeah.
Because there was that whole thing going on. There's no way they were ever going to agree to reunite on camera for me. It's just not going to happen. We'll be wasting our time. So, and I think the team, the production company, the production team had worked for weeks, if not months, on Bring Back Spandau Ballet. And then the whole thing was cancelled. So then they were discussing, they still liked the format. It was an American format based on a show called Bands Reunited. So that's the history of the format. It started in America first, and it was shown on VH1, which was a music channel like MTV, but kind of, I suppose, older music, 60s, 70s, 80s. And on that show, they reunited a lot of famous bands like Frankie Goes to Hollywood, Kajagoogoo. There was a band called A Flock of Seagulls, all these different bands. And because that was successful on VH1 in America, the sister company here in the UK thought, well, we'll try that here. If it works there, we'll try it here. So they came up with Bring Back. And because the format in the States was to try and reunite successful bands from yesteryear, well, that's what we'll do here. We'll try and reunite a band that was hugely successful here back in the day. So they chose Spandau Ballet. That fell apart. And then somebody at Channel 4, who commissioned the show, and I think it was the boss of Channel 4 at the time, a guy called Kevin Ligo, who now runs ITV Studios. He's the boss of ITV. I think it was Kevin Ligo who said, well, why does it have to be bands? Why don't we do a TV show? And I think it was his idea to do Grange Hill.
So, segueing on from that, if it were to come back, would you trust me, would you pass down the mantle to host the next generation of the Bringbacks?
Absolutely 100%, Arch. It'll be safe in your hands.
Well, there we go. I believe I'm now ready to be the next Bring Back host. I've interviewed Justin, I've had a wonderful time, and I can carry with me my signed Mr. T poster and Carrie Fisher's Ewok soap, as well as a complete encyclopedia on how to run the Bring Backs. With all this done, my future prospects ahead of me, there was only one thing left to do.